80% of the children in Lee and Collier counties lack adequate access to food every day. The situation is even more dire the farther you travel inland. In the richest country on earth, the pandemic has our children living on the edge of hunger every single day. Many of them people like you and me who never thought they'd end up there.
Okay, Mr. Caleb, keep moving, baby. Okay.
Mona Albon feeds children at the Good Shepherd Lutheran School.
We have a few that when they leave here on Friday, really don't have much until they come back on Monday.
Hunger is now a fixture in the cafeteria line.
This is heartbreaking to see a five-year-old come in at 7:30, give me a hug and say, I'm so hungry. And they will cry that they want food. And one box of cereal doesn't always do it. You know, you have to sneak them another box of cereal.
Mona herself needed help this summer when she lost her job.
My philosophy when I got laid off was the rent came first and the electric. There were no frills. You want chocolate ice cream? I'm sorry. It's not happening.
She joins tens of thousands of families now depending on food pantries like this one run by Community Cooperative Ministries.
What's the past few months been like for your family?
It's been difficult.
This is the first time Steve's ever been to a food pantry. He's barely worked in months. Even our middle class is struggling with food insecurity.
Good work, guys, good work.
You try your whole life to be in control and then the pandemic comes along and then there's nothing you can personally do about it.
Months into the pandemic, a hunger crisis has exploded in Southwest Florida. Community Cooperative Ministries helped feed 21,000 families so far this year, double the number from last year. St. Matthew's House is also breaking records, handing out food to 10,000 people last month alone.
How many boxes do you need, Mommy?
The need is even greater in communities already food insecure.
Hi.
Record unemployment compounded by the closure of schools and daycares is a recipe for disaster.
Sometimes they cut their hours down to not 40, they get down. So it's hard for them to manage how to do it. But getting these fruits and vegetables, it helps them.
Most of these families don't have transportation to drive to a food distribution. So Guadalupe Center of Immokalee brings fresh food to them.
Do you think there were families during that time that were going hungry because they didn't have anybody bringing them food?
Yes.
Think about that. Hunger in the very community where most of the nation's winter fruits and vegetables are grown.
It's really difficult because like there's no work and there's no transportation. It's hard. So there's times, I think there is times that kids go out without food.
But not Freddie. His belly is full for now.
Food benefits through the CARES Act are set to expire at the end of this month, and that leaves tens of thousands of families in our community vulnerable again.